Hey everybody, it's Spooky Me. Hopefully you can hear me. Can you hear me? Let me know if you can hear me. New interface doing some stuff. We're arting around. Got spooky face because I got the iPad down here on the sketchboard. This is live. You're looking at it. We're going to be drawing some cards. Perfect. Look at this. This is the best stream ever. I'm going to add something real quick because I want to get some audio going in the background. Art stream audio. That's going to play off of what I was listening to, which is... I'm going to see if I can find some other royalty-free stuff so I don't get hit for copyright on here. One moment, I should have set this up. Let's see. That's not gonna work. Pardon. We'll play some of this. Thank you. There was no fart. Yeah, somebody didn't set this up properly. Why is your farts not playing? That's on a different browser thing. Sorry. The farts are disabled. I'll get your farts working on this one next time. I just set this up, so... Just scream fart in the chat. Somebody named me, who sucks, who set everything else up except for this. So, my fault. Keep your farts to yourselves. What are we doing today? We're drawing. Haven't done that in a while. So, we are, I'm working on a project now. I started this yesterday, technically this morning, and I said, what if I design a card game off of just random critters and rules that I'm building on the fly as I go? Like, I have some basic components for it, but right now I'm just kind of building monsters just to do it. Like, I want to do at least one a week. So far I've done a yellow one, and, the yellow one is, I don't know, like, I don't have any other rules for this, so I'll show you the example of the other card that I made. This is a Bingus, and the Bingus is the little Pikachu analog that I made, and he's pretty cool. He's got some special abilities. I'm not going to worry about the special abilities, I'm just going to start drawing. Oh no, see, I'm not going to, because I'm not just going to completely lift the versus system. That is the craziest goddamn story about how that is happening. But I don't think Upper Deck has a leg to stand on. Bingus is pretty good. He's alright. So we like him. We're going to keep going. I've duplicated and have a generic background. To give you an idea, standard trading card stuff. You got your costs up in the corner. These little fungi cubes, just whatever, and then there's going to be a multiplier for how many it costs to put it in play, I guess. You'll get them somewhere, I don't know. You got your knifeys and your shields, which are your respective hit points and how much damage you can take. So you just call it something different, and that's power and toughness. Your bar for doing all of your extra stats, and any kind of special abilities. What am I doing? I'm just drawing random whatever. So if you guys have suggestions for stuff, like, I'm going to start because I just was working on cleaning up this guy. Love drawing this robot. This has been a staple of mine for a while, and we're just going to hang out. So keep me company in the chat. Say stuff. I'll be drawing in Procreate. So this is my tool of choice that I've been using. I have a billion brushes that I've gotten over the years. So lots of stuff here. This is my favorites category. I'm going to move it to the top. Because it needs to be on the top. If I can get it there. There we go. My favorite brushes. And I'm going to kind of showcase how this works. I can make a Dingus. I want to. We could have all kinds of permutation Dingus Dangus. So I drew a rough of this. This is a kind of a guide to how I work. Which may not be the right way to work. This is just how I work. This is a file that I built in Autodesk. Not Autodesk. Affinity. Affinity Publisher. So I'm trying to use that a little bit more than InDesign because I think Adobe is the devil, and I'm switching over other stuff. So let's see here. Other stuff I can talk about. We're working in layers. You'll notice that I've got all these hidden layers here. And this is just the basic template I set up. If I want to do something different, I'm glad you're excited. I didn't know. I've been wanting to do an art stream for a while, and I don't really have the confidence about it. But today I said, you know what? Let's do an art stream. This will be different. Layers, like an onion. Absolutely. So you'll notice I can just change the color to whatever. And I'm just using this as kind of a placeholder just to know where I'm putting this stuff. I do have that program I just mentioned, Publisher. Affinity Publisher. I do have it on the iPad. I'm not going to pull it up because it's boring to watch layout stuff. And I did my rough sketch here. This is something that I did earlier with the pens. You'll notice that there's different abilities for these pens. This one actually does a little bit of streamlining, so if your hands shake and suck. I'm glad that you're back. I'm sorry that you missed the past couple. We've been intermittently playing the Messenger. So, it's been a lot of fun. I've been having audio problems with the actual stream, so I've luckily found a way just to stream royalty-free Spotify in here. And it sounds good. If I'm not coming in loud and clear over the sound, let me know and I'll mute or lower the other volume. So we draw our basics of what we want. And then I'm going to show you what I do. So again, I use these Perfect Sharp Line Art and Line Art Streamline all the time. I'll show you the difference between them. So Streamline, as it says, I've got this on another layer labeled 25 because I have a billion layers. And you'll notice it actually draws pretty cleanly, but it's like there's a little bit of a lag. You may not be able to see it here, but it does try to form an intelligent line. Whereas if I use the line art and do that, well, there's more chance of it, the line quality kind of deteriorating, if it makes sense. The streamline, it's got more forgiveness as you're drawing a line. Kind of hard to say, hard to describe, but to show you, as I'm working, as I typically will use the streamline for a lot of outlines and things like that. Line art I'll use for my finer details. My drawing style sucks compared to others, so this little guy on the right, you won't be able to see very well, but this is the first divot on the top is the width of the brush. You'll notice it's got these little divots that make it. It's like a template. Like it's basically like a 0.005 marker. So if I were to draw with it, you'd notice the line's thicker. If I go to this one, it's going to be a little bit fatter. This one here. And these are just ones that I use all the time. And then this one is the most. I usually keep it around the second one. The thing below it is the opacity. And this guy is the color picker, which I will use for picking colors. I'm going to be working black and white for this most part. But that's essentially it. Notice that line's a little bit thinner, so we're going to go back, do that. This is going to be pretty quick, so I'm going to end up drawing another one too. I'm just kind of drawing various beasties and creatures for this stream. You'll notice that I'm rotating it here. I'm doing that on the iPad with the old twist there. I will typically do that to just kind of get in and focus on details. So hopefully it's not too disorienting. Shouldn't be, but if it is, let me know. You can also draw circles by drawing a general circle shape, but then holding it at the tip, and that'll let you place and do that. Procreate, if you have an iPad, is the best $10 you will ever spend, because it is a flat $10 fee. It is a one-time fee. It doesn't bill you like subscription style like every other app on the store. And you get it. It's yours. It's a full art client that is amazing. It is the best app you can get on the iPad, hands down. Big fan. I would like to do additional streams where I possibly do my comic again. Because I think this would be a cool venue for us to like sit and draw and kind of conceptualize and come up with comics and stuff. I'm long past the delusion of it taking me anywhere or doing anything other than just being a webcomic, but it is pretty fun. I actually don't want those ears on this guy. I drew them, but I don't want them. I have reasons. You have no tablets? Well, if you decide to get a tablet, I'm going to tell everybody what I tell them about Apple and Apple products. Get the most rudimentary iPad there is, because you do not need more. If you can get the mini, it will run Procreate. Anything that has pen support, which is pretty much all of them now, you can get the cheapest one if you can get it on a an educational discount. Do that. There are plenty. Get the last couple generations of them, because you can probably get one for maybe $200. And Procreate's $10. You can load it up and you can do everything. Everything you want on it. I think this is the primary use for this thing. Is this. Daylena got my old tablet when I upgraded this one. This is a monstrosity. Look at this! Look at this first chat from old Haley Safko, who's doxed themselves with the real name. Watching the art stream. Welcome aboard. I play a bunch of Nintendo. No Haley Safko. Get some art going. We got a Haley Safko. We're talking turkey. We're talking tech. We're talking about the iPad. Hopefully, the stream looks okay. Placement for this is kind of weird, so I'm just like adjusting it. So if you guys want to see more of the art, let me know. I'm not able to see the chat while I'm looking down, but yeah, I will look up and then I will see chat. Procreate, as I was telling everybody, is the best $10 you will spend on the App Store. I believe it is still $10. I believe it will always be $10. It is mega awesome. We're drawing a robot. My lovely bride is on assignment in St. Pete. Is not here, but we'll hopefully coming back around 10 o'clock. Docs party! You want me to do it? I'll dox everybody in this room. It's something I do. I sure love giving out the identities. Go away. Go away, Discord. Oh my god, Discord. I'm doing a show. I gotta be more lively on you guys' Discord. I gotta be lively at all or communicate at all. I'm really bad on Discord. This is fun. This is already... Do you think I could do that? That would be pretty cool. You guys could like chat and talk in and stuff. That would be really cool. I might look into how to do that. That's actually a really good idea. We now have a bunch of regulars, so we could just do that. That would be really cool. Maybe you won't. I hope you don't. I don't think you sound like shit, but I haven't heard your mic quality. It could. It would be fine. Okay, so we got this. That is okay looking. I'm of the school of good enough. It's fine by me. Because I am drawing this for myself. And I don't care. If I wouldn't get flagged on the internet for posting material I don't have the rights to, because like some people do, they do watch parties of movies, because today is the 40th anniversary of one of my favorite movies, War Games. Matthew Broderick and the Whopper in World War III and Tic-Tac-Toe and a bunch of stuff. I'm a big War Games fan, and I was thinking about watching that, but you know what? Streaming art, it's just a little bit better than watching a movie I've seen 100 million times. So, I'm just drawing little details and stuff. This is stuff I usually use, like, one or two of the same brushes. I'm going to show you some other effects that I do, too. I like just little, you can see here, itty-bitty lines. This is a space that's 3.5 by, yeah, RIP. Old. I'm going to be older than that soon, very soon. And I don't want to talk about that right now. But that's coming in September. I will be old, old. No bueno. A lot of neat stuff, though, that you can do with this. Like, draw lines. But also, other than just drawing lines, you can do textures. I've got some basic textures here. I'll show you some examples of that and why layers are important. So, obviously I've got layer 25. This would normally be 1, but since I've got a billion layers, it's my fault. You can turn stuff off, because I'm using this as a guideline. And then you have this guy, which I could use as a texture if I wanted to, and I do. Actually, looks pretty cool. And I'll show you some other cool stuff you can do with it. I would really like to use this more for my general design, because you can really make some neat stuff out of it. So if I want to just do that, you can cut things away. I'm going to hide this back layer so you can kind of see what I'm doing. Something like that. What happened in 2021? Me turning 40? Yeah, that was 2 years ago. So that means I'm going to be older than that. But yes, I have been 40 for a little bit. Lower the opacity on this too. Oh shit, I may not get Taco Bell, and the reason why is, I fucked up. Earlier I was looking at, online stuff that, Pizza Hut is doing a limited engagement, pickle pizza in New York, and I was interested in it because it's like pickle pizza, or it's pizza with pickles on it, but there's also ranch dressing on it, and I think the ranch replaces the sauce, which sounds dangerously unhealthy, but it's pickles on top of it, like actual dill pickle slices. And I looked at it and said, I'll order this beast right now, but apparently it's a limited engagement, but staring at pizza means I'm going to order pizza. So I ended up ordering, thank you very much for that. I think that that's the correct answer, is this pickle pizza sounds delicious, because other places make it, but Pizza Hut decided to do it. I just fly it in. Just fly right in. Here's your very cold, disgusting $150 New York pizza with pickles on it. So the pizza I ordered, we got the tastemaker. We got the 3-item special, which you cannot upgrade to freaking stuffed crust, which is bullshit. I got the large. I got the following ingredients on it. Mushroom. Green pepper. Pepperoni. Standard fare. It's like almost a supreme. Stuffed crust is best pizza, period. Absolutely. Even Pizza Hut, which has let me down lately. I may not keep this texture. I'm gonna mull over this, but just to give you an idea, this is something I can have. You can soften it to get that. That's pretty cool. I may keep it. I have not tried the Big New Yorker yet. I saw it and they're like, oh, them 6-inch, the 6X slices, you can fold And I'm like, yeah, that sounds really good. When they do it, their Detroit pizza is no joke. The Detroit, like, the freaking box pizza, that is the business. I am a big fan of that. So, because I ordered Pizza Hut and I had Taco Bell earlier, not this week. I didn't get it this week. I really can't. I can't. I've already spent too much on fast food. I don't want to spend any more. But, okay, so you got your volume turned up and you can be more engaged in chat. Yeah, we're just talking pizza. You're anti-everything Detroit. RoboCop is from Detroit. You're not anti-RoboCop. You better not be. We'll have some words. I was drawing. We're talking about pizza. So, I did get that pizza. It was pretty good. It did get a 2-liter, I got a 2-liter Mountain Dew. I felt so damn bad for the delivery guy because as he pulled up, it freak occurrence just started pouring rain. He got out. I'm like, bro, I feel so bad that you got out in the pouring rain, and he's like shivering. It's like, here's your pizza. And I gave him ten extra dollars for a tip because I was like, you haven't seen RoboCop? Oh man, this means several people in this chat have not seen RoboCop, and that really upsets me. This is further cement that I need to basically violate copyright law and just play RoboCop, because I'll do it. I was drawing this arm. Man, I mean, it's good. Wrong pen. It's good to watch Bob's Burgers renditions of things, but the original, especially in the case of both RoboCop and Blade Runner, that's the way to go. You gotta do it at least once. I watched RoboCop this weekend. Oh, it's on, you can watch it right now on Amazon Prime. If you have it. And if not, you can look up something on your internet saying RoboCop free, and you can give your computer the old LimeWire AIDS and just watch it somewhere and get a billion pop-ups and watch the movie, which is something that I've done sometimes in my youth, because sometimes you don't want to get up and put in the DVD. But write that down. Gotta watch RoboCop. You gotta watch it at least once. It's the most fun you will have with a movie ever. And it might change your opinion on some parts of Detroit. Probably not, but been enough of it. Okay, so here's old Klampski with the second clamp. And we got all these details, right? We got all this stuff. He's looking pretty alright. I'm going to show you some other effects here, and then I'm going to kind of draw something else. Oh, yeah, Just Watch is a great one. Yeah. Detroit is a big con. Like, the wrong kind of con. The only reason I kind of like Detroit is because RoboCop is featured in it. And fun fact, most of RoboCop, other than like the direct like intro flying in, is not shot in Detroit. It's shot in Houston, which I guess is supposed to be a substitute. And they think, oh, it's the same thing. And when it's like, no, it's not. There's no snow anywhere. It's like humid. There's signs in the background that say Texas. Like, it's pretty distinguishably not Detroit. But what are you going to do? The answer? I don't know. If I had to get a Pizza Hut rating on how my pizza was, it's going to be 4 out of 5, which is a lot better. My poor bro that delivered the pizza, though, I did give him 10 extra dollars for the tip because he was shivering. I felt bad, so I did a good deed for the day. Always tip your people that deliver food. Always do it. If you have done it, if you've ever done it, tip those guys, because man, it sucks. There's so many rude people and now murdering awful people. There's a mini police station, I always assume. Yeah, you just put them in there. You gotta tip people. You gotta do it. It pisses me off when people don't tip. Take care of people. Alright, so look at that. We're getting there. I mean, normally it take I'm a lot quicker with this, but we're talking turkey. We're talking turkey. We're talking pizza. But we're talking turkey about pizza. You're too cheap. Nah, that's fine. I normally seldom do either, but I don't have a car right now. But hopefully, in less than 3 weeks, after 4 months, I will have a car again. And I will be able to go places and do things. It has been tough. It has been very, very tough. It has reminded me of being a surly 15-year-old. Even though... What's the car story? Well, I told you when I got in an accident. Right? And tell you about my car accident? I gotta get out of here. Yeah, for sure. It's turning me crazy. Got in my car accident, when was it? It was in February, because I was coming down for a work function at Pizza Place Secret Stuff, and several of the people in this chat are aware of what happened, because I was driving down, it was February, and, a Penske truck drove into the side of my car on 75 as we were going, and completely fucked up the side of my car. Highway Patrol was absolutely not helpful and said, well, I don't know who's at fault. I got both your stories and you both said you didn't do it. So, that was enough to say I'm not at fault, which meant he didn't have to pay for it and I didn't have to pay for it, and my insurance is paying for it. Yeah, it's not the best. Not a big fan of that action. Don't ever get in a car accident on 75 by having a truck get in the wrong lane. The old pizza, yeah, the old pizza invitational. We'll totally do one of those again. Guaranteed. We should do another one of those. It was fun. I had more fun with that with you guys. But, the activities itself. But. So we're going to fill this in. I'm going to add some of this texture here just to show you what you can do with this. And also, the good news is because I'm working on a separate layer, is that you can draw and not affect the other line work. So check this sweet action out. I may be the only, well, I say this, and that's a bunch of horse shit. Who remembers Zipitone? Oh geez, I'm sorry. RSVP Invitational, we hardly knew ye. Oh damn, I am drawing on the wrong layer. That is why I'm an idiot, and we're gonna do that again. Okay, so check your layers. Other important advice. Sometimes you can relabel your stuff. I'm gonna call this halftone. I'm gonna call this inks. Because sometimes I can know. No idea what Zipitone is? Zipitone is a sheet, and they typically use it in, you're gonna love this, you're gonna love my pronunciation of it, because that's just how I'm gonna do it. Your manga. Your manga, you would lay it down over a piece of art, and you get his X-Acto knife, and you cut it and scrape it. And what it would be these textured sheets to create the effect of a halftone, like what you're seeing here. And this cool little pen that I found is a dot shader that kind of does the same thing. I'm a big fan of the Zipitone style, and you have some artists that are still in comics and stuff that still use it. It's very antiquated. It doesn't really show up a whole lot of places, but, hey, subscribe for 6 months. What are you doing, Josh? The dude that got me and the old battle axe hitched. Contributing to the stream. Thank you so much. We are going to be at Sebring Pride supporting Button Witch and doing Pride button stuff on Sunday. We will be there, I believe, most of the day. We do have to come back. We're unfortunately in a situation. Thank you very much. Very excited. Look at those two subscribers. The Zipitone's neat. It's I'm all over the place right now because I'm coloring, I'm talking about Pride, I'm talking about Daylena's buttons. I can't stay in Sebring that day, unfortunately, because my parents just got COVID for the first time, and they're dealing with that. They're okay, they're on the mend, but we can't stay like we thought we were going to be able to. So we're going to stay as late as we can. And Day's going to be selling Pride buttons and selling all the stuff, all the things that Day's been working on. We're super excited about it. It's going to be a hell of a lot of fun. So I can't wait to be there. Looking forward to it. We got our booth coming together. We're going to have all the stuff set up. But check out how cool Zipitone is, because you can do all you can do this. I'm using kind of the same brush that I'm drawing with. Look at everybody showing up. What is going on? Look at me drawing. I fucking put up an art stream and people actually show up. Easy Goodnight, welcome aboard. We're talking about doing Twitch calls. Everybody believes in my art. Jesus Christ, you guys are sweet. It's been a hell of a day. This is nice. You fucking tell somebody you're gonna play some fucking Zombies Ate My Neighbors, nobody pops up. You tell them you're gonna fucking draw a robot, here we are. So, you know what? We're gonna be doing more of this. I gotta find a schedule that'll work for this, just to intermittently do some art stuff. Because this is cool. This is a great venue for it. I miss stuff like live stream, and it was so choppy and junky. I'm getting messages. A robot. We're excited for the Pride event. We really are. We're excited to be there and support Josh. Josh is so great. Josh was the dude who did the reception for us, and amazing reception. We obviously were very, very, very happy, and you're always, you know, friend for life through anything. So can't wait, you know, or can't wait to be there. And I'm hoping that I can get Day into doing a little bit more art and talking about this stuff online too, because I think it's pretty cool. I know we all have our comfort levels of what we want to do, and I mean, honestly, I feel uncomfortable as hell drawing, because sometimes I don't know what I want to draw, but then I also realize I'm okay with playing shitty video games and being terrible at it and it being fine. So, anyway, like I said, that would be cool if they could do, we're talking about the, what? I got noises coming. The deleter piece. I don't know if I did. Do you have a link to it? Can you post it in the chat? Can it show up? I don't think we can post images and shit, but you can post like a link. Maybe I can get to it. Was it one of the ones you had at the studio, Eric? I have 8 people viewing. 91 followers. If you guys get additional followers in here, I'd really love to hit 100. It would be super cool if we did. But no pressure. Man, that's a big turnout tonight for me. So, we will be doing more art streams then for sure. Drawing naked ladies. I'm not drawing naked ladies. That's Eric's bit. I'll start a Patreon and draw naked ladies. Hey! Thank you, August. Hello, Crispy. Yeah, I know, right? Okay, so that's our robot, basically. And he looks pretty good. So, let's talk about this. Let's talk about where he came from. He looked like that. I laid down my inks. He looks like that. The Zipitone made him look like that. And it's pretty cool. I don't hate it. I might do some other stuff to it, though, because you can do lots of things. What's neat about this shader is that I can go back in on my halftone layer. Oh, neat. Can I pull it up? Oh, crap. So, you can see what that did, and that looks like crap, so we're not going to do that. But I can use other brushes as erasers and do things like this just to kind of give it some gray. some different fades, some different effects. Stuff that you can't really naturally do with Zip-A-Tone, but it's fun to say too, Zip-A-Tone. I want to look at it. It won't come up for you guys, unfortunately, because I'm streaming off this screen. Oh, I saw this at the show, man. Or I saw this at your studio, and I was going to tell you about this. I thought it was amazing. See, man, me and Goodnight here could totally talk about Zip-A-Tone and this kind of style, because we have so much in common with just fascinations with different art styles, particularly Japanese art in the regards of, like, the PC... what is it, the PC-98 palette and display from old computers, and just classic. I mean, we've got a lot of similar interests, so when we get going, and we've been on, like, podcasts and stuff, too, where we've just kept going for hours talking about cool shit that we like. So I've got to get the chat going, or the voice for this, so we could talk about the stuff while we're working, because I think it would be really cool. That's something to think about. This is a really cool fucking stream format, and I wanted to do this for a while and didn't think it would do this, so, like, again, set this up. So yeah, anyway, I'm having a blast. Back to this, though, I might want to do something else. So say if I wanted to do, there's a lot of neat things that you can do. Let's give it some background. Let's do some kind of background effect here just to do it. There's different ways you can do it. I've got, like I said, I've got a bunch of brushes. I'm actually going to use, these are just my favorite brushes, but there's others that exist in here, and I've got not enough time to go through them. Just too much stuff. I need to get some square brushes. Oh, there they are. Well, those aren't going to be good for this. So, anyway, I'm actually just going to freehand stuff. You can use a lot of brushes to get some cheat effects. But, like, say if I wanted to do, like, just a background effect of something, just some abstract shapes. Is that full opacity? Is it? You can also swatch and palette stuff. Since I'm usually working black and white, I've got the Lawman card art. Yeah, I guess that is black. I was telling everybody I would love to do comic panels and stuff. What am I using? I am using Procreate. Yeah, I refuse to use it for iPad because it's a subscription service and it's more expensive than anything else. Procreate, I mean, I love Clip Studio, I really do, but I'm not paying for it monthly when I've already paid for it on my, you know, my computers. I won't do it. It's too much, and it's not worth it. I think the interface is better on Procreate for this stuff. Subscriptions need to stop. It's ridiculous. Before I stopped, you know, I still hate Adobe. Yeah, I mean, I've done it once. You know, I think some things make sense for the subscription. If I were to get a subscription from Adobe again, which I am not a current Adobe subscriber, I would get one for InDesign only because I use it the most. Because it's the only tool worth it. You should build everything in InDesign, period. No, I mean, that's the thing. There's options, and it's what people are comfortable with. Illustrator is neat. I've actually been using it more lately. But, you know, there's your free options. You know, there's always going to be, like, your Inkscape or your Scribus, I think, if it's still around. Stuff like that. Like, I will tell you, I've been trying to learn Publisher. I keep forgetting the damn name of it. Affinity Publisher. Because it's $50 and it's a flat fee. And I don't really want to use the other art. 10 people? What the hell is going on? We've never had 10 people in here. Inkscape can go to hell with GIMP. Okay. That's fair. There's a ton of, like, iPad-based Illustrator ripoffs that work just fine for this stuff. I don't know. I'll let you guys fight this. Yeah, I mean, I wanted to use Publisher because I want to have a desktop publishing solution that doesn't cost me a bunch of fucking money just to maintain it. I don't think it's fair that Adobe wants to charge. I think for a single app, it's still $20 a month, and for the full suite, it's $50, and it's just too much. I mean, especially where I'm at, like, I'm not doing this, like, professionally enough to where I can justify it, and I want to. But I just don't like giving Adobe that money for no reason. That's my fault. I need to market my own shit better. I need to be at shows again. Speaking of which, I'm coming back and I'm doing my first art show in maybe nearly 10 years. I'm going to be at the Punk Rock Festival in Lakeland, which they were really excited to get me. And I've got to draw new shit and I got to have stuff ready. So can't wait for that one. So we're gonna draw some buildings here. This is pretty cool. I'm gonna add some more effects. We'll see this. The show for that is, they need to add you. sorry if I'm slow on responding. I'm not used to all of this fucking activity. It's in September. I'll give you a little bit more detail. I think it's after my my birthday, which is the 17th. I'm not 100% sure, but I'll get back to you on that. It is there. Day will be there. We're going to be splitting a booth, doing Button Witch stuff, and I will be there. I don't know. I might be drawing some sketch cards live or doing, like, caricatures or something. Like, I want to do something different and something that's outside of my comfort zone, but still fun. Yeah, that's true. You cowards need to know that I'm a professional. So, look at that. We got some buildings here. I'm channeling my old Jim LaFood here. A little bit of Justin Peterson here. See, that's what I should be doing, but see, that's your gimmick. We lost a viewer talking about gaping buttholes. Don't worry, they'll be back. I'm just secretive. Yes, I am Goatsy. You know nothing of my work. I wonder how Glass Ass is. I hope he's okay. That fella, he had a real trick. We often talk about internet we miss. Even gross ass internet. Kinda miss that, sort of, to a degree. I mean, slightly, but not really. I say that, Daylena looks up so much, better be careful with this one, not anything like that, but like open surgery, like stuff like, oh, somebody's cutting open a finger and doing that. I'm like, yeah, fuck this, can't do that, that's too much. Well, some windows or ceiling there. I'm going to show you some other tricks though with this now that I'm doing it. This thing I'm doing here is the slow way of doing a fill. You can also click continue filling. That looks pretty cool. A stretchy butthole! Look at this! First time chat! Oh my god. You remember Meat Spin? You could set your watch to it. Ah, fun. Talking about gross stuff. We're all class. Old class ass. The farts aren't set up. I that's the one thing I didn't do for the stream, but next time the farts will be enabled. So we can be farting around. Oh. What the hell is going on? The farts aren't set up. The farts have been disabled. Holy shit. You guys are killing me tonight. This is great. So, again, this is the cool thing about this brush, is it is pressure sensitive, so you can get those darker details of this. God, I know this is nothing but a fucking Joan and Vasquez rip kind of style, but I would love to do a book and make it look like this. Just to fucking do this. It's a shame I hate comics so much now. Like, so much. What a fucking scammer is. Yeah, well, sorry. Next time. See, if I do this, then I've got an excuse to do my Patreon shit again. Oh, man. Look at you. Your website card inclusion. They do include color options. I do have alcohol markers that have the color. That's an important thing. Joe Rocks Art. You can follow me on Joe Rocks anywhere online. The website to get commissions and stuff. I will have color options available. I think when I do the cards for the show, or anything, I think it's going to be $10 a card. Really? That's pretty cool. I'm going to include color options for sure. So if you need anything, always hit me up on the contact thing and chat me, and I can, I'll work with you. Pardon me, excuse me. Full that pizza, that 4-star Pizza Hut pizza. Oh man, we got to get this fucking chat going. How do you like to set up? Okay. This brush I've lucked out that this was a pre-bought brush that I got that I really just kind of fell in love with. And I think it's in the pack that I sent you, but if not, it is so tricky to get these balances where you like them. And it's hard to describe, but I'll talk about this a little bit. Yeah, well, there's a fart in there too. I was just quiet about it. Let's click here. So this is the brush studio. And we're not seeing all of it because it's cut off on my screen. But to give you an idea, you have all of your options here on the side, and it's just a lot of math here. You can set up your spacing and kind of see the effect. It'll show you, you'll see, like, here it's showing you the dots, because you can make, like, an actual spaced out stuff. We're going to go all the way to zero here so it doesn't space out. The jitter adjusts how the brush spaces out. The fall off is where your taper is. I don't really mess with that very much either. Stabilization, I usually keep it around the 22%. 20 to 25% pressure stuff and all this, I leave at 50. And taper I don't really mess with, but you can taper those edges off if you need them. I don't work with a lot of flat brushes, but I should. You could just use CSP and you don't even have to fuck with any of this. That's absolutely right. There's a lot of great brushes, and I have lots of great brushes here, so I usually just kind of go from the default. Grain is important. This is one that's actually really helpful, especially for the pattern brushes. I'll show you what I mean about that. Grain, for instance, you have the zoom, and you'll notice how it changes that actual pattern brush. This little setting here is a godsend because I'll just kind of crop it however I need. And if I want like a thinner kind of display with this, or like a thinner effect, I'll change the zoom on it. Thank you very much for the follow. I don't have it set up on the screen where it's going to show that, but I need to turn that on too. Again, this was a rush job to get this set. Your rendering, your blending, all of this stuff. You can do all of these different things, like changing the hue of your brush if you're working with paints and stuff. I don't mess with this as much, but you can set a lot of the dynamics up, how it works with the pencil. Every single brush is so mutable. Yeah, thanks, but this is broken. That's the story around here. That's how it works. I don't think about this stream until 10 minutes before. I was eating pizza and drinking Mountain Dew and saying, you know what, this is fine. Materials, this is interesting. This is a new one. This is for the 3D stuff, and I haven't fucked with any of that. There's a 3D... rendering software on here called Nomad, something like that. I don't know, and I don't fuck with it. I need to learn how to do it. I've been watching some videos of some guy doing 3D modeling, and saying, yeah, that would be one of those things that I should learn how to do and don't know. But yeah, there's a lot of options in here for customizing brushes. These two that I keep here on the top, which is the Perfect Sharp Liner, and then the Streamline, which just has that, a little bit of that extra carry, is pretty cool. I'm going to show you guys one more thing. Since I've got a great example, I laid down a bunch of this base color, and I might want to go back through and clean some of it up just to make some cleaner shapes. Like, let me zoom in on that. Show you what I'm doing. I'm just doing this for effects, just to kind of clean up how this looks. Just kind of personal preference, things to kind of make these claws stand out. And then you'll notice other stuff, like I've got some stuff going off to the side. And there's a lot of quick ways I can do this. You can use your guy up here, which is the squiggly line tool. It's next to the magic wand tool. And the squiggly line tool lets you pull up your selection options. You can do automatic, which lets you select an area. And I can clear it out this way. Nope. Oh shit, you know what I did? I messed that up. That's what I did. So you can do a freehand thing where you can click on your space and kind of use this as your lasso tool. And then just scoop that out of there on the right layer. Come on, selection empty. Okay, that's fine, we'll do it again. So I usually use this for spot cleaning on some areas if I'm doing any flatting or stuff with colors. I'll explain what that is. Why is this not moving? Interesting. Oh, it's because I'm on the wrong layer again. Yeah, it's in there. I'll find it, and if not, I'll send it to you. It was part of a pack that I think I paid for. If not, yeah, I'll find the proper, if I paid for it. I'm sure I did. I love getting brushes. There's a new set right now that's it's a Photoshop filter that does intelligent gradient stippling. It looks really good because you can turn it on and off in certain areas, and it works off gradients rather than just solid colors, and looks pretty cool. I want to look into that and see how bad it is. I hate getting Photoshop actions, and I hate paying money for them because a lot of them aren't very good. Or they don't do anything close to what they advertise. And, you know, somebody I know taught me that, you know, you should be able to do most of the stuff yourself. Like, you don't have to rely on actions and brushes and shit. You should just find a way to be able to do it yourself, because it's part of the craft and part of the fun. I don't fault people for using them, but I think sometimes, you know, getting there is another part of the discovery with the art and doing that. As I'm drawing of a fucking murder robot. So, anyway, something like this. Oh, Frank's on. Super RPG Friends is a great stream. And it happens about the same time as mine, so I can never watch it because we are constantly streaming. But I wish one day, if I'm not streaming, that I could hang out and watch Frank, because he's pretty cool. Works with Premium Games, maker of fine physical Switch products. Pretty cool guy. Anyway, what are we doing? So I got a couple options of things I can do. You know, right? We have all our two gradients. I'm going to merge these down. So we got our gradients if we want to keep them. We got this background layer. I'm going to call it background. And I'm adjusting where these place. So. And then I'm actually going to group them all together in a group. I'm going to call it Robit. It's called Robit. Photoshop has so much stuff. It's so tricky. And it's so annoying. I've been working with it. And I learned new amazing things with it. And then one day I learned I don't want to draw on it. This is a robot. It's more gas, like it's basically more engine than my car needs. Oh, that's a home starter. So I didn't inherit with with your tone. It's obviously went over my head because I'm doing Strongbad's voice, and I'm pretty sure that Strongbad didn't say that. I know the Homestar, though. Who's everybody's favorite Homestar Runner character, though? Because mine is Homestar. Yeah, I know, you can't. You could bracket. You could bracket Home. You could bracket Strongbad. Or, yeah, it is Homestar. I do like the cheat. Daylena cannot stand Homestar Runner. Totally missed out. I love Homestar. Homestar's not real, but I mean, he is and he isn't, but I love a Homestar. Oh. I miss fun internet. I miss Glass Ass and Homestar Runner. I miss these being the two things you do on the internet. You watch a man sit on a freaking mason jar. You watch freaking Strong Bad emails. I would love to. I hope. Are those guys okay? I don't ever hear anything about what happened to them, but I would love to draw some old bootleg Homestar Runner shit. Because I'm a big fan. You know what? Who wants to see some color? I'm not going to color these typically, but for my idea for this, but I just want to do some color to show you guys how to color. Who says yay for color and art? Who wants to color some art? Let's show you how this works. I'll show you the old ways. Oh, I didn't know you wrote for Gravity Falls. That's pretty cool. Color is dumb. All right, color it is. We're going to turn off the halftone layer, which is now relabeled 28 for some reason. Half tone. Boop. And now we're going to turn this off. And I'm going to show you guys how to color. This is how I color. You take your inks layer. You duplicate it. You move it down. You pick a color you like. Let's make this guy red. He's not going to stay red, but he's going to be red for right now. And I'm going to show you how I color. You see a little color blip on the top? You take it. You drop it. You hit continue fill. Oh, you fucked it up. Boop, 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 boop. You fucked it up. Line's broken. Here's what we're going to do. Show you what I'm going to do. We're going to close off these pieces. A good handy way of not seeing where your lines are broken is you can turn off your background layer. And I'm going to get my pen tool and close up these old pieces here. That might be it. I'm going to have to worry about those edges, but I'll worry about that in a minute. We're going to turn the background back on. We're going to pick our color. A good quick way of doing that is the color picker tool here. So let's just pick our color. You drop it. Continue. And I'm just going to go ahead and select all the stuff that needs to be in color. And if something's missing, I'll show you how we get around that too. See, there's a couple things, but I'm not too worried about it yet. I'm gonna make this here and make this here. So I do this just to kind of cover the That's pretty great. Like, just sounds like him by default, or like, is it just like a decision to just sound like Dana Snyder? Either way, it's a good thing. Hey, old alert, who's excited about Venture Brothers finally finishing up? I mean, I am. I remember the Venture. That's the best. You can't beat that. Dana Snyder's default voice is the Master Shake voice, so it's a good thing. Oh man, it's so good. So good. Very fun. well-crafted television. And nobody ever watched it because Adult Swim just let it kind of disappear. And that's fine. Why is your robot so angry? Well, he's pissed off because he's a robot and robots kill. And that is how this works. I've been drawing this default robot as like just a default like angry robot sample. And I've been drawing this guy since like high school. Just pissed off. That's what robots do. That's the best robots. The old clamps. Oh, I realized. So I'm using the lasso tool to color regions now. And I like how that looks. That's pretty good. Oh, we know why you call them. The bucket tool is terrible. I have to do area effects and stuff with this because the region fill in Procreate leaves a lot to be desired, and it's very fuzzy. It has a lot of issues. Hey, who wants to watch me do something really gross? I mean, this isn't a Patreon channel, so where's my fucking drink? I'm not doing anything super, super gross, but I am drinking from a 2-liter bottle. Yeah, well, I'm an affiliate. I can do what I want. No, I'm just drinking poison by the gross. No finger mutilations. Not yet. No, it's not Baja Blast. They don't sell Baja Blast unless I go to Taco Bell. And I discussed earlier, I can't go to Taco Bell because I had Pizza Hut earlier with my 4-star pizza. Not 4-star pizza, but I gave my pizza 4-star because it was okay, but not great. So, we got our base color on this layer that is labeled inks. I'll rename it color. Any other thoughts with the interface? Yeah, I miss 5-star pizza because it was right next to Armada Games when I actually liked going to it. But that was a very long time ago. Let's color these eyebrows in too. So, let me show you this here. So, when I hide the layers, you'll see this is where all the inks and the area effects have been done. You'll see the inks here, and I'm going to do something here where I duplicate the ink layer, and I merge it on top of the color. The reason why I do that is it maintains the color and the line, so if I have to select a layer, it's going to be easier for me to get to. That is why I do that. So then, I'm going to take this layer again. Actually, I could take either the color or whatever. I'm going to do this, and I'm going to start placing some arm stuff here. Can continue filling. That might be it. Here, we're going to do this. It won't do it. Interesting. Oh, it will, but I'm an idiot. Okay, I see why. Yeah, he's looking different. I mean, but the thing is that I don't have to use this color scheme, and I'm going to show you another thing about it, too. This is just kind of like showcasing how I work. This is an introductory art stream. So as I do more of these, it's going to be kind of generalized. But this is more like a kind of a showcase of features. So, boy, that new Transformers movie looks like another pile of poop. I remember being excited for seeing at least the first movie of that when it was a thing. And I was so sorely disappointed I never bothered with the others. Izzy, okay, cool. I mean, if you're getting help from this, yeah, let me know. If there's anything you want me to do, or if you have any questions, I have no problem answering this stuff. I really love teaching this stuff. This is mainly, I mean, it's a tool for me, but it's also a tool for you guys. If you're getting something from it, yeah, let me know. So I appreciate that. Thank you. I'd like to do more of these in the future where I start teaching this kind of stuff. because I think there's just a lot of knowledge, and I think, you know, I want to see more people do art and do cool things. We're going to color these. So right now it's basically the J.J. Abrams Bad Robot, which I don't like, but that is unfortunately what it has turned into. So I put all my color on one layer, and that's good and bad. You can do that however you want. I usually like to consolidate stuff. I'd love to do a basic art stream, like something that I can show like the concepts of stuff. Because what I'll do after this, it's only 8:05. I'm gonna keep going until 9. I'm gonna start over with something new. Because I'm just fumbling around on this guy. But I'll start another sketch where I can show you the whole process. I don't normally take this long on these. These are usually quick, one and done kind of deals. But okay, so he could look something like this. But what's really cool is why I do these layers is, remember our halftone layer? Look at that. It's pretty cool. Gives it a lot of dimension. Yeah. I put it right there. Yeah, I was laying the base colors because what you can do from here, I cheat with this. I'll show you my shading trick. So you got your color, and I'm going to name this shadow. If I wasn't using the halftone, which I'm going to turn off right now, I'm going to show you what I do. Is I will go, and I will either, there's a couple ways I can do this. I can either select everything and fill it black. Thank you very much for the favorite. We're 93. Yeah? I didn't know that at all. That's cool. That's what I wanted to do for a long time for comics, believe it or not. I don't color as much, and I'd actually like to go through and get like some scans, some decent scans of some artboards and work on those. Because I the overall process of coloring is super fun. So the shadow effect, like I said, this is a black layer, and these have the layer, different layer effects, which is how light passes through them. There's too many right here for me to really go through, but I'd color your work. Yeah, send me some work. I'll color it for fun. No problem with that. I love doing that. You notice the opacity? It blocks the stuff out. Like, the multiply, it traps everything except the darker colors. Screen is the opposite with that. It traps all the light. You have different things which are kind of like splitting the middle of it, which is overlay, which looks something like this. And other effects which do different things. For this purpose, I'm going to use multiply. And I'm going to lower it to about 40% of what its normal brightness is. You can then treat this like basically the same thing with Zip-A-Tone, where you get your tool, which I'm using right now, my pen, to act as a lasso. Maybe. We're going to select a region. Kind of draw what you want to draw. Draw just kind of a shape. Just have fun with it. And you peel it up. And you can manually go in with your erasers. You can change this. I'm just kind of erasing that space. That's pretty cool. And also, if you want to do something where you add shadow to it, it's as simple as getting the pen, picking up your layer, and just drawing black on top of the layer. And you can add the shadows back. And you can do a lot of fun stuff with this. And add that. You can even add little effects if you want. Like if you wanted to have divot eyes or something like that. If you want to add little dents, imperfections, things like that. Whatever you want. And it's real simple because it's just basically the one effect of the black. It's important to know your light sources. I am the worst example of this because all of my work is sloppy cartoon bullshit. But if you have a general theory of it and want to make it look good, you know, this is usually the starting way. No reason why you can't do multiple layer effects with that. I keep it as one because I like the flat cartoony look to it, but you can do additional things to create different additional effects. I'm going to show you an example here real quick. So I'm not going to select that yet. I might do something different with the panels. I think I fucked that up. Yeah, I fucked that up. Connection didn't happen. Okay, so again, just scooting this off canvas and it disappears into the ether. Not all art programs are like that, but Procreate kind of works that way. And you can see here, look at that. You can use your pen tool to manually erase. I've got this set on eraser right now. I'm erasing the spots. You can lighten these spots. Well, it's different. It's an acquired thing. Not everybody's a fan of it, and I don't blame them for that. It's what works for me. This is the stuff that I like. This is the kind of style I like. I'm no stranger to say that, I mean, obviously there's art styles that I really like. I like cel-shaded artwork. I'm a big fan of the vibrant colors from the Jet Set series, things like that. What was that game that just came out recently? The rhythm game that was basically like Jet Set Junior. I started playing it on Xbox and then stopped because of something. But anyway, that kind of vibrant, sort of like cel-shaded kind of look, and this is kind of close to that. Like, it's not perfect, but it's perfect for me. I'm having fun. The most important thing with your art, who gives a shit what other people, detractors and stuff say? As long as you're having fun with it, as long as you're proud of what you're doing, then you're not a bad artist. You know, I think. I think that, you know, that's the goal. Is it supposed to be expressionist and fun for you? And I think, what is going on here? Why is this not selecting right? Having issues with that. Yeah, I mean, do whatever you want to do. Who gives a shit? You know, this is your time. This is a luxury that you can afford. This is something that you can do for yourself. It's just draw, you know, draw, create, do whatever. I'm happy to do more of these as like an instructional thing if you guys are interested. I think an ask me anything while I'm working would be really neat, because I would be able to be a little bit more receptive. I've got the headphones on right now, but it's mainly just to hear the audio stream. But anyway, so the thing that's funny about this is the final version of this won't be colored at all. This is just coloring for you guys. So, again, selecting color means that you can go back with your brushes. You can go back with your brushes. You turn the color fill off and do automatic. And you can select regions like these, for instance. And let me show you another thing. Since we're working on this, since I've already shown you the shadow, you can see the difference here. And you look at this and you might say it's too much, and then you can go back and modify your halftone and say like, maybe it's too much on the top. I want to go back in here and clean this up and like come back in here and say I want the top to look like this. That's pretty cool. Whatever you want to do. But I'm going to show you the different lighting effects that you can do with this. I'm going to make a new layer, and I'm going to call it overlay, because I'm actually not going to do screen yet. This robot layer has a couple of different placements. You've got your ink layers, which are still there. This is my in case something fucks up layer. Your background layer, which is all the extra crap I drew. The halftone layer, which is all the halftone that went onto the robot. And then overlay, shadow, and then your original sketch. I'm going to show you overlay and what you can do with that. Overlay is interesting because it's like 50% of what you're working on, I think. So if I use white, it's going to be 50% of that, and it's going to kind of split the difference. It's hard to describe, but easy to show. I'm going to show you now. So if I take this white layer and I draw here, well, that's going to be pretty much white. But if I took black and I drew black on it, am I drawing the right layer? No, I am. I'm a bullshitter. What am I talking about? Okay. So those are a little bit heavier. Ignore what I said. Usually what I can do... This is a good example to show you the difference between multiply. So if I do multiply, you'll notice that the bottom is still dark, but the white disappears. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I was trying to find the best way to describe it, because it's definitely... thank you very much for doing that. I'm definitely going to pick that up and work on some more. I'd like to just work on this as like a general excuse to draw. So I appreciate that. Let me change it back to overlay. Oh, you know what's stupid? Yeah, that's what it's doing now, because I didn't have it on overlay before. I'm an idiot. I was staring at it. It was on normal. Normal light, you can see the white. If I do screen, you'll notice that the black disappears from the bottom. And overlay does that mid-tone split the difference. That white is more like a pronounced red. So there's a lot of neat effects you can do with that. Like if I wanted to do highlights with the right color, not a black, but a white, do something like that. Or something like that. And it just adds just general little pops to your art. You can use it for whatever you want. Little glowies and things like that. Whatever you want to do. Kick lights is a good term for it, yeah. I mean, you can do lots of neat little stylized things. You just get that extra shine on the metal. Things like that. It just make it kind of fun. So it's pretty cool. Pretty cool for what it is. But let's say I'm doing this. I'm going to duplicate this so I have a backup to go back to. Say I'm doing this and I say, God damn, I don't want this guy to be red. The reason why I layer things like this and I don't flatten them yet is because I'm always uncertain of what I'm doing. And this is what's really cool about digital art, is that you can take... If you have your layers flatted like this, and by flat I mean it's just a flat color with no additional detail, you can do something like this. So I'm going to turn all this off. I'm going to show you a thing. I don't want these reds to be that. I want it to be blue. So I pick a blue that I like. I draw it. I fill in the areas that I want. You can do it this way, the faster way to do it, honestly. You could do hue saturation. There used to be a replace color. I don't know where it is anymore. But there's a lot of ways you can do it. I'm just going to do this right here to do the fastest way. I'm going to select everything. I'm going to do... hue saturation, and you can do a quick color change on stuff. If you don't want to affect the eyes, you can do something else where you can get your select tool, you select everything, you do remove, you do this. What did I do? Why did I deselect it? Well, you can change just the eyes. Let's make these gray real quick. Say I wanted it like that. And then I wanted to make it a blue robot. Say I wanted it to be more gunmetal, kind of. Like that. And what's cool about this is I can turn all my layers back on. And you'd never know a thing. It's quick to where you can just sit here and say, let's see what other options I have. What if I want them to be purple? What if I want them to be kind of a rusty kind of color here? What if I want to brighten this here? And the cool thing about it is because on the colors on its own layer, you can do that. You can also back it up and keep this here. So pretty cool. Like, it gives you a lot of options and you can explore kind of stuff as you're working and you figure that out. I'm going to do one more thing before we finish up here. Thank you for the follow. We're at 94. Can we get 6 more? Tell your buddies. Get them on the internet. We're going to be excited if we can get 6 more. Thank you. I'm a big fan of this stream today. You guys have been awesome. It has been an interesting time, and this helps. Definitely want to do more. Okay, so same thing as before. I'm using a background layer. I'm going to place that as like a general skyline. I don't want the bottom part here, so I'm going to draw a shape. I'm just going to cut that away and make a little horizon line. Photoshop has the advantage of other tools. I'm having a great time for this. Photoshop, everything like that. With Procreate, you're kind of limited because it's mostly touch-based and interface-based with pen. So you have to do things a little differently. So a lot of this theory, layer theory, all that stuff translates otherwise. But a lot of the stuff like drawing simple shapes and things like that, it gets pretty cumbersome. I'll get into that in future stuff. So I'm trying to color the apocalypse back here. And I said, this is cool, but I want to get some more glowies out of it. So I'm going to pick something complementary, like a lighter yellow. And I want to use an overlay. We're going to draw some manual shapes here. Pardon me. There's that on-brand burping. So we got this. We got their effect here. And that looks pretty cool. And I'm going to add one more thing. I'm going to actually do it again. With another overlay. Notice that it's not quite white, but it's still that lighter color, that canary yellow. And you get something that looks like that. So we'll zoom out and we're like, it's pretty cool. What else can I do? Well, this background is on a separate layer. You notice that's kind of neat. But let's try something. Let's just see how it looks. I might be overkilling it, but we'll see. I'm selecting all of the text on the background layer. And I want to use a darker purple. These are just different palette swaps I've gotten from places. You can keep your own color palettes and stuff if you want. Usually I'm kind of eyeballing this stuff manually for myself. Whatever you feel comfortable with. Sometimes it's good to have like a set. Like whenever I'm doing lawman art, I've got different gradations of gray. I got this. want to deselect it, we'll look at it. This might suck. The good news about this is if you're working in digital and you're like, this sucks, you don't have to keep it. You can get rid of it. It's not doing a whole lot for me. I'm just adding some different billowing tower effects of... Not what I wanted. I'm gonna make that bigger. I'm gonna probably change the color of this. Probably gonna change this guy back to red. And then I'm going to change the color to this, to something else. We're going to use our hue. We're going to change it to a red. Try it without that light real quick. And lower it just a touch. You can also do overlay with this stuff too. That gives it a nice look. It's pretty cool. So, you've got all of your layers. That's what RP started as. Let's go back through what we did. Procreate has a lot of different ways of showing this stuff. I don't have it set up to do the one thing I wanted to do, but I'll do it next stream. So let's look at where we started. We started here. Just drew a rough with some pencils real quick. Went over the pencils with the inks to make it look like that. Laid down my base colors. Added some halftones, which are available if you do the multiply layer or not, which gives it a different look. This is probably how it's going to look. Added a background layer. Added the color. Added some shadow effects. Can change up the color. Added some little background effects on the color. Let's flip that back on so you can see it in red. See it with the gun or the metal texture. We can leave it blank, but that doesn't look right, but it's kind of neat. Add your halftone again if you want. So there's just a bunch of different ways you can do this, and there's additional effects that you can add on here too. You can even draw over top of the inks to create other effects. You'll notice everything that I'm doing is behind that, but you can take the color. If I add, you'll notice that this is above the lines because it's drawing above them. And you can do a lot of neat stuff, like just various textures. It's not even being good with it. It's just you know, practice. It's just practice and learning this stuff. I mean, I don't know. I've been doing this for a long time. I wish I was further along with it. And the thing is I learn stuff about it all the time just by using it. It's definitely a sandbox. It's a sandbox that you can benefit by having this knowledge. I've never formally had that knowledge. This is all stuff that's self-taught. So, but anybody can pick it up. You can add other stuff too. I might actually show you one more thing we can do. I know I keep saying that, and we're at the 8:30 mark. Let's add something. I want to show you how screens work. And screens, again, they capture the brightness of something and they omit the darkness, the dark hues of this. So what does that mean? Well, if I set a layer to screen, call it screen, I usually use this for faking some highlights, and you can use it with white, but what I'd like to do is take a complementary color. Let's take this old baby blue here and we'll test this out. We'll see how it looks. It might look like shit. You can pick an edge and you can place something here. And what's cool about it is it's placing this behind the line work. And it's creating this little effect here, which I kind of like. Again, you can do the same thing. You can select it all. You can change the color of it. Say if I don't want this, I want it to be an orange. You can do that. Let's fill it, see what it looks like. Makes more sense for the drawing. Yeah, you've got a lot of heat. You got a lot of stuff you can do. Other things you can do, if we're talking about changing the overall feel of something. Let's try this. This might suck, but it's all about experimentation. You can go here. Place this big blob of color over everything. Why? Because I'm going to change it to another layer effect called add. And add will do something that looks like that. And if you adjust the colors, it can create a feeling of warmth or additional color. You can also do fun stuff like get your textured erasers. I love to use this color wash one. Big fan. You can create something like this, and you can fake a hand-painted look just by running it over. And you can erase sections of it. Actually, let's see what it looks like. I'm going to turn that off. You can place something like that. Adjust the opacity just to get different effects. But it's pretty cool. I mean, it's not bad. Again, a lot of experimentation gets you where you need to be with it. So, yeah, anyway, this is whatever this robot critter's name is. I don't have any stats for him or anything. The experiment, like what I said, is I'm just going to draw random cards for a game and draw art until I get a complete system of what the art looks like. You can do a quick pinch and it zooms in on this. My final of it is going to look something not like this at all. The color was just for you guys. I'm duplicating the layer group because when I get done with it, it's going to look something pretty boring by comparison. I think it's just going to look like turn it on. Oh, I did. So that layer's still on. Probably something like that, just to be perfectly honest. So, anyway, it'll look like that. If I want to turn the halftone on, I can do that. The other cool thing is that there's multiple halftones and stuff available. I keep saying that, like I'm done, and then I'm like, oh, but I want to go back and see more. Because I've got lots of brushes and stuff, things that I like. You could do lots of stipple effects if you want that. Stipples are cool because you can get different textures. I'm a big fan of stipple artwork. There's a lot of role-playing, old 90s era role-playing games that use a lot of stipple artwork, and it always kind of gets me in the right mood for this sort of stuff. There's a lot of good examples and stuff that I hopefully will be able to talk about and show you for reference material and things that I like in my art. Is it the new Sonic? Is it the new one they announced today on Summer Games? The Superstar? I bet it was. Sonic! Oh, Sonic the Fast. Oh, boo. Yeah, never mind. Just diarrhea. So you could add something like that. That's a cool halftone. There's a set that I found not too long ago that is a short and dense, and you can do some really neat stuff. It'll warn you if you're not on a layer. This one you have to use sparingly. and you have to adjust the size of it with your drawing, which is where that zoom comes into play. Actually, is it the scale? Alright, well anyway. It's a great blender. Or it's a great, yeah, for creating dark stippled effects if you want to make like some dark tones. Not going to be as much for this metallic shape, but it's pretty cool. I actually like this brush a lot and we'll have to use it more. It's kind of weird when you have favorite brushes. Most food can give diarrhea. Okay, but again, you could do the same thing. Cut. Adjust the shape. Just kind of place around it. You can make some really neat effects. I mean, right now he's got the texture of a carpet, but looks pretty cool. If you were going to use something for fur, or yes, the Eastman TMNT brush, as it were. Love that brush. Love that Joker. It's pretty good. But I could mess with this stuff all day. And I won't, because we're at the 836 mark. Let me show you one more thing. Let's see. What can I do? We've already got an excellent robot drawing that we're monkeying around with here. I want to do something else. When you're done too, you can also flatten this to make it a solid layer. That way you don't have to worry about things happening to it. I keep this by default. This is when I was working with all of the other stuff. This was the Bingus that I started with. Where's the Bingus that I started with? Why is the Bingus not appearing? Oh, because that's there. Yeah, there's the Bingus. I'll add all the text and copy. I definitely will. I'm going to check it out right after the stream. So I'm excited about working on some of the stuff. We've been needing to collab for a long time. It's amazing I've known you this long and we haven't collabed on stuff. And I'm not saying that as a guilt or a fault or anything. I just feel it's shocking that we haven't. So I'm really excited to work on some stuff with you. Anyway, there's a Bingus. Let's draw something else. Let's draw a not Bingus related thing. I'll show you the general process. I'm just a dick. Lots of brushes, lots of things that I can start with. Studio Pen used to be my pen of choice. Each of these pens have different looks. You'll notice it as you select them. These were all favorites at one point. Flat is flat, non-textured brush, which doesn't have any taper to it. People swear by this one. You can do lots of artsy farty pen effects. I don't care for it. It's not my style. Untitled brush, I don't know. Maybe I was working with something. It's got a fuzz to it. It's kind of neat, but I think this is probably a mistake brush that just needs to be deleted. I'm looking to see what else I have. Broken sketcher, watercolor, penciler. Okay, you can use your pencil. Oh shit, I'm drawing on the wrong layer. Gotta watch that. Lock your layers to make sure that you don't draw on the wrong things. I love the Bingus. Yeah, I do. So, pencil tool. What should we draw? Should we draw a Metroid? Let's draw a Metroid. I'm going to show you something else cool. So, when you're drawing this, I'm using a pencil tool now, just to kind of come up with something. And we're just going to draw this. Say if I wanted to draw a symmetrical piece. Procreate's got you covered with that. You can do a drawing guide. And you can edit it. This is a lot easier than it looks. You can turn it on, hit done. Procreate does this badass thing where you can do assisted tool thing. And check this out. So if I draw on this side, you'll notice it's drawing on the other side and it creates a symmetrical drawing. Yeah, it's just right there. So it's kind of cool for like if you're setting up quick shapes, things that you want to do. I know since I'm drawing a Murtoid. It's really cool. It's not useful all the times, but it is useful for some of those times when you're wanting to do pattern stuff and things that are neat. So you can kind of set up your basics of this, and then you can adjust it and turn it off. Like if I wanted to turn it off, I just click on drawing assist, and you'll notice that it's off. So, pretty cool. Again, working with a pencil brush means that it's going to try and simulate actual media, which will look pretty good for the most part. This, you can get a lot of this. There's also shaders that you can get, or blenders that will do some of this stuff. I'm going to turn on this one, the Salamanca, and you can do different effects. I don't use this often. It's good if you're doing a painterly style. It's just not for me. I should. There is a massive difference. The Moktroid is much easier to kill because it is a fucking sham. Anyway, so I've drawn my basics of what this guy's going to look like. It's basically a Metroid. I think he's probably got too many teeth, but you know what? That's fine. Got the lumps of old Metroid meat here. And then the nerves come out. I've never drawn a Metroid before. I'm just drawing this from memory. So I'm sure he doesn't look anything close to what he's supposed to, but also kind of does. So he's kind of turned out pretty cool. I really like drawing monsters and critters. I've learned that. I can come up with some neat shit. I don't get much of an opportunity to. So we got our pencils. And we like this. If you don't like the size of it, you can go through and resize it. You can either freeform it, which means you can adjust it like so. I don't. I usually do this or this. If you're working with a drawing guide, watch that center line. You can stylize it. You can warp it. You can change little things about it. So I'm going to keep it basically like that. I played, Super Metroid on the stream, not too long ago, and it was a three-part stream, and I kicked its ass. Man, I had a game, it was one of those nights where I think I just couldn't sleep, and I beat Super Metroid, and then was playing it, and then I said, could I beat this game again? Could I beat this game in less than 2 hours? And then I picked it up, and I did, and, Thursday Night Monsters and shit. Drawing some old fucking goopy monsters. I could do that. We're going to drink from the old 2-liter. My completion rate was shit, but I did beat that game in less than 2 hours. SLTN I know pretty well, and I can do most of it, but I can't 205 it. I need to get better. Super Metroid, yeah. I love the fucking Mountain Dew. Let's go back to the art here. You guys keep chatting me up. Rando Race SOTN. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's talk about that during Halloween, because Halloween is usually simply in the nighttime. That's the, excuse me. What are we playing it on? Are we playing the Saturn one, or are we playing, Well, I guess Saturn's unemulatable. So I guess we're playing the PS1. The PS version. Oh, thank you. Excuse me. Yeah, that would be really cool. I would actually like to see who could do that. We could probably team that up. Yeah, I don't like the added shit to it, and I've never been a fan of it. People tell me that it's the best version, and I think that they're fucking high. So, we got some goop. We're gonna add some old Metroid goop. This might be a good time to do that tool. I'll show you again. You can set it back up since the layer's here. See, sweet action. You can set up your basics here. I know that the periphery of this thing's gonna roughly be the same. Some old jittery line stuff. I'm deliberately shaking my hand to get the effect. Go have your Frosty. I need to get the randomizer set up for that. Arg's got their own stream and it's gonna start later, so everybody should go check that out if you're not, but you probably should. I need to put more people up over the top with this stuff. We're a community of friends here at the old Jurox Art Retro Night video game night slash now art stream night. Just gonna draw some old gross veiny veins. It doesn't need to be super complicated because this is just for a quick show. I don't want them to be too symmetrical, but just enough. Yep. Just draw with them feet. Or nipples, whatever. Okay, so I'm just gonna do these basic orb shapes. What are these brain clusters? I don't know the anatomy of a Metroid. I assume that that's what that is. Do a general cluster here. Let's take a look at it. Roughly what it should look like. I'm not clicking that. Oh no, I know better than that. Well, symmetrical is kind of cool because you still get that uniform look, and you can turn it off at some point to mix everything up. I'm gonna turn this back on though. Turn that down. Yeah. I mean, you guys don't know. You're like, what? There's got to be a legit link. You know, the one damn thing I didn't show off, but I always like to do heavy outlines on stuff. That's okay. We're gonna do it here. The iPad makes this so much easier than it used to be. When this was just Wacom tablets on screen, oh my God, what a pain in the ass that was. The old Graphire tablet or Intuos tablet. Like, I think the hand-eye difference between being able to look at this and do it, it's night and day. The technology has gotten so much better. I envy people who have been able to do this and faster and better, but you get there by practicing. I have been out of practice, but I still work on things. I believe it. I think it's a preferential thing. There's sometimes when I do miss it. With the Intuos, because I think there's a level of pressure and responsiveness that's there, and it's a difference. It's like a mind's eye kind of thing. Like, I don't know. I think, like, with the Cintiq, I have the, it's back there, and I never use it for pressure sensitivity. It's the, what the fuck is it? The XP pen? I bought a replacement after I sold the Cintiq. I think I sold it to Whitmack. Just because I was like, I don't use it. I don't use it for anything that it's, you know, needed for. Like, I don't get my full mileage out of it anymore. And I bought the XP pen as a replacement, and I'm like, this is cool, but then I'd rather, honestly, now just use Percrate and the alt pen. So we'll notice here that I fucked up already, and you've got some stuff, like, covered up. Like, I've filled in the layers. So what I can do now is I can do that. Let me merge it down. This is where I can kind of mix up those veins and stuff like that to make it unique. I'm gonna add some other line texture stuff just to make it there. The Metroids are semi-gelatinous and sort of see-through when they prop on your head. Oh no. Daylena won't be home until 10:30 or 11. I gotta sit up for... Day's been working so much today. It's like a 14-hour day. So I gotta make sure they're okay. Okay, so we got this, right? It looks pretty good. Yeah. Maybe it's just me. I mean, I don't know. Like, I think the Cintiq is a novelty, and I think it's really fun. But I do notice the problems with it when I'm working on stuff. The iPad just really has just been killing it for this stuff. It's not, like... I don't know. Like, the thing is, I don't think it could do any better. Like, you can keep adding Retina displays and all this other stuff to it, but the thing is, it's pretty perfect the way it is. I've got this thing here, which I will advertise for. It makes my giant iPad even bigger. but I have the Sketchbook Pro, or Sketchboard Pro, and it's got little fold-out things if you want to fold it out. But it does literally make this just essentially a lighter, more portable Cintiq. It's got edges to it if you want to put shit on it. Like, I lean on it. It lets me draw and keep my hands free, so it's essentially just, like, a portable desk option. So it's taking something easily portable and making it more cumbersome. But for this, I don't know. I really like it. I saw Scotty Young talking about it, and I was like, yeah, I could fucking buy one of those. If it's good enough for Scotty Young, it's good enough for old internet famous Joe Martin, I guess. Whatever. Look at that. Look at that bright ass green. Notice that I put the wrong layer up there. So I'm moving this one to the back. The reason why... Damn it. This is my ink layer. This is my color layer. We're just going to call it color. I don't name them. I'm doing this for show. That's why I have layer 42, 49, 152. Whatever. Okay, so the color's there. Ink's here. And I want to do this real quick because... You son of a bitch, dirty dog. So that is his outer. Nice. We're gonna do this for the inside layer. Appreciate you guys sticking around for a little bit more while I'm finishing this up. This will not take very long. I may make... Actually, I better not, because I know somebody in this chat that made Metroid stickers, because one of them is on my laptop. But... And I better not make Metroid stickers, because old Grandpa Nintendo will sue the fuck out of you for using their franchise that they hate for things. Grandpappy Nintendo, he gives you a stern looky-loo on that one. Does not like it. Okay, so that is roughly where that looks. I think I can do some really cool shit with this. Let's draw some old guts here. Some old Metroid brain guts. I'm gonna make a sublayer below the color. And the reason why is that I can draw in color right below it. You see that green right here? I'm drawing right below it. Because I can. I didn't know you could do that. I mean, that's a mod, right? See, you do that. You go in there and pop in with all your mod content, all your stuff, and I'm always like, I don't want to get lost. I don't want to be frustrated trying to find shit or fuck with the components of this game. And I need to. There's some mods that are really neat in games. Particularly that game. Old Hackerman. I'm going to speed this up just a touch here. We're just going to color a region. You know what game I haven't played on... Thursday night retro game night is Color a Dinosaur, and I think that might happen, I don't know, in or around my birthday, because Color a Dinosaur is one of the worst games you can play, because it's a Nintendo game where you can color a dinosaur in 16 colors using your controller. It is just as exciting as it sounds. 16 of them. Look at that. Beautiful. New season of Fortnite. Holy shit, I don't care. I'll get on there and draw some fucking Mario Paint. Like, there, I miss Mario Paint. I had a blast with Mario Paint. Mario Paint Randomizer. They have that Mario Paint music composer where you can make longer tracks, because people were doing that shit for like a hot minute. I was a big fan of that. That was a full entertainment suite. You get a lot from that. Let's draw some old... Again, you can color however you want. I'm doing this a little different with this one because I just know this is some mucusy grossness inside your Metroid. I love a Mario Paint. I would pixel. That was my intro to doing pixel stuff, because I didn't have a computer for, like, a modern computer for a long time, and that was my, sit here and learn how to pixel and draw, like, Nintendo Power had the guide that came out that showed you how to do, like, all these, like, intricate pixel designs that you couldn't really do anything with, and you ran out of room. But, damn, I loved a Mario Paint. I want this Metroid to look more damp. And its teeth need to be the right color. So that's going to be next. So. I'm just here, just little lines, little things like this. It gives it some grossness. It's pretty cool. I mean, honestly, I don't have any complaints about it. I'm gonna draw on top of the ink layers. I'm gonna add some blue. This is what I'm talking about. Just give it some dimension here. this is like what I say, I don't really draw monsters and shit, and usually when I do, I find it very therapeutic. This is neat. Just an old moist Metroid. Super moist droid. Ignore that, I shouldn't have recorded that. That's disgusting. Go directly to hell, Jim Martin. So, I'm gonna add some shiny layers here. You can do that however you want. I'm using primarily one brush for this. But I'm gonna show you a trick when I get done with this too, because I'm gonna do something cool. Maybe. How gross he is. Oh, did I disable clip? Ah, fuck. I guess we missed out. You can do a highlight in there. You should be able to. If you can't, let me know. I'll turn it back on for this kind of shit. Okay, so I'm going to select everything else. We're gonna turn that off. We're going to flip it. I'm going to add one more layer. I'm going to make this like a... That's fine. That's like a Metroid teeth. Yeah. Hell yeah. Kind of want his teeth to be a different color. Those are neat, but maybe a little bit more. Oh, that guy. That's my fault. I'll turn flip on there. I didn't realize that Chris O'Dowd was really that bad until people talked about him. And that's unfortunate, because I sure did love that show. I still sort of do, but it makes it tough. Let's do something else. Let's do another thing. I want to add... You know how we added those shades last time? I know we're getting done. Oh, glinter. Yeah. Okay. I was talking about IT crowd. I thought you were talking about... My mistake. Sorry. Yeah, I believe it. Let's lower this to about 40%. I'm gonna get a brush that's got some shit to it. Okay. Well, yeah, if you guys are heading out for pizza and stuff, I'm just gonna finish this up. I'll be done in the next 5 minutes, promise. I'll work quick. I'll work quick. You guys are gonna bounce up? Oh man. Okay, well, appreciate you guys coming by. It's been a fun stream. I'll do another one. I don't know what the schedule should be for these. If I want to keep Thursday night for games, and then I don't know. Now that I've got a viable thing that people want to watch. I'll figure it out. Yeah, I'm almost done with it. It's not going to be that much longer. I'll post it on the internet, as it were. Pretty gross. Looks pretty good. Normally his teeth should be longer. Every other week's pretty good. Yeah, it's listened. His teeth are too short. That's my problem with it now that I'm looking out at it. It's not so bad. Alright, let me do... Alright, I keep saying this. I keep wanting to fuck with it. I could do it every other week. That breaks it up a little bit. Yeah, I could do that. I'll tell you what. Why don't I plan to do this in 2 weeks? I'll come back and draw some more card stuff or whatever and get that set up. And we'll do that. I think in this guy, I'm just going to say he's done. Does that sound good? Let's say he's done. Just group them together, call him a Murtoid. Good old Murtiod. He's here. And yeah, so everyone, thank you so much for watching. We did not get 100, but next time we'll have to. So if you don't watch me next week when I'm playing freaking video games, you can watch me do art the week after. We'll just do an alternation. So I'm doing 2 video game streams and 2 art streams. So hey, shit's getting done and recreation is happening. You can't beat that. Period. So appreciate you guys watching. Thanks for checking out the stream. Really appreciate it. Thanks again for the other the 6-month subscription. That's super freaking awesome. Yeah, this has been a great time. This has really helped my mood, and hopefully you guys have enjoyed the stream and what we've been doing. And we'll do more next week. Do I have a sign out? Let's see if I do. Where is my sign out? Guess we'll do the closeout, the other one. So anyway, thanks a lot.